My name's Jay Fisher. I'm the solicitor for the zoning hearing board. The first matter on our agenda is the application of DET Investments, Inc. For variance for property at 260 Norwood Road. For those of you who may not be familiar, I'm going to go through the procedure that the zoning hearing board will follow. And that is that initially, the zoning officer, Mr. Uhas, will put certain matters into the record on behalf of the borough. Once he has done that, we will turn the hearing over to the applicant to establish a record in support of the application. I know that we only have one party who has requested and been given party status. If anyone else is interested in becoming a party in the matter, Mr. Uhas has applications at the front desk. You have to complete and submit the application. Once the applicant has completed their part of the case, then we will open the floor to comments by anyone who may be interested. If you intend to make a comment, we'd ask you to stand up, give us your full name and address, and spell your last name. We do ask you to, if you're simply agreeing with somebody who's spoken before you, you simply can tell us that you agree with them. You don't need to reiterate everything that they said. So we do reserve the right to limit redundant statements or testimony. Mr. Uhas, are you ready to proceed?
Yes, I am. This is for BET Investments. Exhibit B1 is the application as submitted by the applicant. Exhibit B2 is proof of payment for this hearing to proceed. Exhibit B3 is the public notice for this application. And it's application number 2017-001. It's for BET Investments, Inc. on behalf of Park Lane Associates, owners of 260 Norwood Road, which is in the I-1 Limited Industrial District Zone, for variances to use, minimum side yard, and lot width. Exhibit B4 is the proof of publication from 21st Century Media. Exhibit B5 is the certificate of posting that certifies that the property was posted as required. And B6 is a certificate of mailings confirming all the proper notification to the adjacent property owners. And that's all I have for the book.
Thank you, Mr. Uhas. Those exhibits will be made part of the record. Is the applicant ready to proceed?
Yes.
John Anderson.
Robert Alexander.
Raise your right hand. Do someone swear or affirm the testimony you're about to give will be the truth, the whole truth, and nothing
else? I do.
Thank you.
Good evening. My name is Carrie Nace. I'm the attorney for the applicant at the law firm of Fox Rothschild. Here this evening on the property located at 260 Norwood Road, which is approximately 3.8 acres and is zoned I-1 industrial. This property is currently improved with a building that's used for auto repairs and parking for inventory of new and used vehicles in connection with the Roberts Auto Mall. The proposal that's before you this evening is for the construction of an addition to the existing building to handle overflow from the current operations. It will continue to be used for auto repairs. There is no auto body work currently being done or proposed to be done in the building. But it will also include auto detailing and washing. As Mr. Uhas indicated, we are asking for a variance to continue a non-conforming use on the property, as well as variance to side yard setback and the lot width requirement. Both of those items, which are also currently non-conforming with respect to the existing building. I do have two witnesses here this evening, Mr. John Anderson, who's the engineer on the project, who will present testimony regarding the site plan and variances being requested, as well as Bob Alexander from Roberts Auto Mall, regarding the business operations. I have submitted up to you a packet of exhibits, which we'll go through as we move through the testimony. I mean, if I may, then I'd like to start with my first witness, Mr. Anderson. Mr. Anderson, what's your occupation?
Hi, good evening. I'm John Anderson. I'm a principal partner in Cornerstone Consulting Engineers and Architectural Incorporated. I'm a civil engineer licensed in the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania. And I am a managing partner that directs our civil engineering program in Cornerstone.
And could you please describe the type of licenses that you currently hold?
I hold a license for a professional engineer in the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania, as well as many other states, the surrounding states, New York, New Jersey, Delaware, Maryland, Virginia, and several other states. Also a licensed professional engineer, practicing civil engineer.
Great. And marked in the exhibit package, exhibit A2 is a copy of your resume. Does this accurately reflect your qualifications?
Yes, it does.
I'm asking that the board recognize Mr. Anderson as an expert in the field of civil engineering.
Ms. Shields, do you have any questions?
I do not, thank you.
The board recognizes him as a professional engineer.
Thank you. Great. Mr. Anderson, are you familiar with the subject property?
I am.
And what is the current zoning of the subject property?
I-1 limited industrial.
And could you please describe the subject property and the improvements located around the property?
You want to look here.
Right. If you could refer to Exhibit A3, the aerial, and just describe the surrounding area.
Basically, the property, as was indicated by Terry, is located at 260 Norwood Road. To the north of the property is the eastbound ramp of U.S. Route 30. To the west is Norwood Road, and just to the west of Norwood, on the opposite side of Norwood Road is the continuation of the industrial, limited industrial district, and it is a liquid propane or a gas commercial facility on the opposite side. Just to our south is it's a vacant land, it's a zoned residential in East County Township, and to our east is a residential subdivision located within the borough of Downingtown.
And what is the current use of the property?
It's currently being used by Roberts Auto as an accessory storage lot, a minor repair, vehicle washing and so forth, but mainly storage of inventory on the property.
And to your knowledge, is that use permitted in the I-1 zoning district?
No, it is not.
And are you familiar with the uses and improvements that the applicant is proposing for the subject property?
Yes, I am.
And marked as Exhibit A4 is a plan that was prepared by Cornerstone with the last revision date of 3/7/2017. Were you personally involved with the preparation of this plan?
Yes, I am. Yes, I was.
And was this the plan that was submitted with the Zoning Hearing Board application?
No, it wasn't.
And could you please describe for the board how this plan differs from the one that was submitted with the Zoning Hearing Board application?
The one that was submitted as part of the application was based on information that was provided to me by the client. It was a representation of the property, the existing improvements on the property. I believe it was done by a previous engineer. However, we were authorized by our client to update the survey of the property. So our office, with my licensed surveyor, Steve Romick, surveyed the property and updated the plan accordingly. There were some minor changes with respect to the boundary that we had originally submitted on the plan, with respect to the existing building location, so we updated the plan accordingly. And that's the plan that's before you and submitted. And I have extra copies, full-size copies, if you're going to need them.
And marked as Exhibit A6 is a rendered copy of the zoning plan. Are you familiar with this plan?
Yes, I am.
And could you just generally describe the project as depicted on this plan?
The one that's contained within the handout or Exhibit 6 is the same plan that's before you on the board, or mounted on the board. It's the same rendered plan except it's enlarged to scale. Basically, this plan represents the property, subject property that's before us. It shows the existing improvements as well as some proposed improvements. The existing improvements consists of just under a 5,000 square foot building, a main entrance drive off Norwood Road. As you enter into, on that asphalt entrance drive, you would proceed towards the east or towards the rear of the property. And again, this outline with the hatch around the perimeter is the existing building, and the proposed building is located also in the same color, but it is not hatched or outlined. It's just under 11,500 square feet building addition. The rest of the property is a large asphalt area that's represented in this rectangular shaded in a dark gray, and it is the accessory parking that's associated with the use.
And could you please describe how the location of these improvements were determined?
Again, the existing improvements were based on an updated property survey. The proposed improvements, which consists of the 11,446 square feet or 11,500 square feet to round up, is a proposed building. It's located in a way so that all the new service bays, the building will contain 24 new service bays, four proposed detailing bays, and that's located in order to access an existing overhead door on the existing building so that cars will enter the building and proceed through the existing portion into the new portion, so that all the proposed maintenance or minor repairs or detailing will happen inside the building and not on the lot itself. The proposed addition, and I have a plan that we can show, is basically designed so that we can limit the amount of impact on the surrounding property by containing all the improvements, the repairs and detailing inside the building. And that's primarily how this structure was designed and built by the architect.
And are you familiar with the Downingtown Borough zoning ordinance?
Yes, I am.
And did you attempt to design the improvements shown on this site plan in accordance with the zoning ordinance?
We did attempt that, yes.
And are you familiar with Section 287-53A of the zoning ordinance?
Yes.
And what does that section provide?
287-53A is basically the permitted uses within the I-1 or limited industrial zoning district.
And is the applicant's proposed use of the property and the proposed improvements permitted in the I-1 limited industrial zoning district?
No, it's not.
And in your professional opinion, will the proposed use have an adverse impact on the surrounding properties?
No, I don't think it would have an adverse impact. It's basically a continuation of the existing use and providing the proposed maintenance inside the building.
And are you familiar with Section 287-54B of the zoning ordinance regarding the minimum lot width at the building setback line?
Yes, I am.
And what is the required minimum lot width?
The minimum lot width is required to be 250 feet.
And how is that 250 feet measured?
Yeah, it's measured at the building setback. I would like to back up a second and describe a little bit more of the existing property. As you can see, this property used to be a rectangle. However, it got reduced in size due to the eastbound ramp of Route 30, which necked down the section of the property located closest to Norwood Road. And by doing that, our lot width of 250 feet would be located well into the property, almost a third of the way into the property. The existing structure that's on the property today does not comply, is set back closer than where the lot width is located at 250 feet. And where it is located today, it's approximately 165 feet in width. The lot itself is 165 feet in width, basically located at the building setback.
So currently, the existing building is non-conforming with respect to the lot width?
That is correct.
And how wide is the lot at the start of the proposed addition?
It is 180 182.79 feet.
So the lot width that the building addition is greater than what's currently provided, but still less than the required 250, is that correct?
That's correct, because as you proceed towards the rear, the lot widens out.
In your professional opinion, could the addition be located in an area that complied with the 250-foot setback?
To comply with the 250-foot setback would separate the two structures. As I indicated before, we're locating the proposed structure so that it joins the existing building to make sure that all the repairs and maintenance of vehicles, the washing and detailing, will be contained within a building. In order to comply with the lot width and the building setback for the new section of the building, it would separate the building and therefore push the proposed use even further into the lot and creating additional hardships for building expansion.
And are you familiar with section 287-54G of the zoning ordinance regarding the minimum side yard setback?
I am.
And what is the required side yard setback?
Minimum side yard is 50 feet.
And does the existing building currently comply with that requirement?
No, the existing building is set just under 30 feet at 29.9 feet.
And does the proposed building addition comply with the 50-foot setback?
It does not.
What is the proposed setback for the proposed addition?
37.6 feet.
So you are able to provide a larger side yard setback for the addition, but it still doesn't meet the 50-foot setback, correct?
That is correct.
And why were you unable to provide the 50-foot side yard setback with respect to the proposed addition?
In order to contain all the service bays within the proposed building, if we were to comply with the setback requirement, it would misalign the interconnection between the existing building and the proposed building, thus skewing the bays, and it would most likely require doors on the exterior of the building, roll-up doors for vehicle access on the exterior of the building.
And to your knowledge, has the applicant discussed the proposed project with the equitable owner of the property immediately adjacent to the south of this property?
Yes.
And to your knowledge, what were the concerns of the adjacent property?
Basically, work that would be performed outside the building along the property line, access doors associated with the proposed structure, any windows, any lighting. They were concerned with making sure that there would be screening associated with that property line. Basically, increasing impacts to the adjoining property.
And has, to your knowledge, has the applicant agreed to certain conditions to satisfy those concerns of the adjacent neighbor?
Yes.
And has the applicant agreed to install buffering along the property line to minimize the impact that this project would have on the neighboring property?
That is correct. And what we're showing on the plan before you, which is part of the update, was an agreement to show, it's kind of in a dark brown shading, but it's a berm, a 3-foot high berm along that property line, an evergreen, row of evergreen trees, and one deciduous tree and some additional evergreen shrubs along that line. And I believe that the applicant has agreed to work with the adjoining property owner's landscape architect to place them in a way that the landscape architect and the adjoining owner are satisfied.
And will the proposed addition increase any impervious surface on the property?
No, it will result in a small decrease of about 1,200 square feet of additional green on the property.
And therefore, in your professional opinion, would there be any additional stormwater runoff associated with this project?
No, the proposed building addition is located on existing macadam and asphalt area, part of the ability to set back. To push the building further away from the side yard setback, we were able to reduce an existing row of asphalt along the rear of the building, or the side of the building.
And are you familiar with the requirements to obtain a variance as set forth in the zoning ordinance and the MPC?
Yes, I am.
And in your professional opinion, are there unique physical circumstances or conditions peculiar to this property?
Yes, there are. As described in my testimony previously, the lot next down towards Norwood Road, due to right-of-way for Route 30, which decreases our ability to provide the lot width at building setback. It's an existing use that's on the property today. and we are pushing the proposed building back from the side yard and keeping proposed improvements located within it. So I believe we're not increasing any hardship or adverse impacts on the adjoining property.
And in your professional opinion, is it because of those conditions which create an unnecessary hardship, thereby making the requested variance as necessary?
Yes.
And in your professional opinion, do you believe that the variances, if authorized, would alter the essential character of the neighborhood or substantially or impair the appropriate use or development of adjacent properties?
No, I do not.
And why not?
Again, this is an existing use. We're reducing impervious coverage. We're adding additional landscaping and screening and berms to try to reduce the impacts of the proposed building. We're attempting to locate all the repairs, all the maintenance and detail inside a structure, thus by keeping all the noise and any odors or what have you associated with the use inside the structure itself, and basically keeping the use of the property the same as what it was prior to this proposal.
In your professional opinion, do you believe that will the grant of the requested variance represent the minimum relief afforded and the least modification possible of the regulations?
Yes.
I have no further questions for Mr. Anderson at this time.
Thank you. Ms. Shields?
I don't know the question that I have is best directed to Mr. Anderson, so I'll wait until the presentation is done. Thank you.
Thank you. The board have any questions?
Can you just clarify the existing impervious that's being removed, the area? Is that to the south of the building?
That's correct. Basically, the asphalt area extends in this rectangular fashion and extends all the way to the existing building. So we're removing this strip of asphalt behind, to the side, I guess, or to the south of the proposed structure. All the existing asphalt is all the remaining asphalt is to stay.
Then can you just clarify the existing use of the property now versus the proposed use, if there's any differences? I know a couple, I'm sure maybe it was a mistake, but you mentioned repair a couple of times. I don't know if that's supposed to be part of what's going to be happening in the building or not, but can you just clarify the existing versus the proposed use of the property?
My understanding is that there are minor repairs that are conducted today and that there will be a continuation of those minor repairs on this property. Additionally, there are four bays located in this section of the building that will be for vehicle washing inside the building, also detailed.
And our next witness, Mr. Alexander, will be able to better explain the both current use of the building as well as what's being proposed.
Any other questions for the board? All right, thank you. Call Mr. Anderson.
Mr. Alexander?
Mr.
Alexander. Sure. Where are you currently employed?
Congress Hall.
And what is your occupation?
Service director.
And approximately how long have you been with Roberts Auto?
27 years.
And are you familiar with the subject property?
Yes, I am.
And could you please describe in detail the current operations on the property?
All new cars, Hondas and Subarus are delivered to that property versus in town. The vehicles, when they're delivered to the factory, new, go through an extensive checklist. We've got to make sure the vehicle's ready to be delivered to the customer. That is down there. It's free delivery inspection on the new cars. A used car that's traded in any of the Subaru or Honda is sent up to this lot. It's inspected. If we decide to keep the car, whatever repairs are needed, brakes, lights, whatever, are done at that facility. And then brought back down to Honda or Subaru. So we also store new vehicles.
Is there any body work or painting performed on the property? And with the new addition, is any body work or painting proposed to occur on the property?
No.
And to your knowledge, approximately how long has the property been used for the type of operations you just described?
12 years.
And what is the proposed use of the building addition?
to repair the Subaru shop in downtown, literally up front of the facility. We'd like to move the Subaru repairs up to that new facility.
And so generally, it will be the same, but you are adding vehicle detailing and washing, is that correct?
Correct.
And I've marked as Exhibit A5 in the board's packet is a copy of the floor plan for the proposed addition. Are you familiar with this floor plan? And could you please generally describe the proposed addition as described on this floor plan?
The used vehicles that are brought from Norwood will be repaired again in this area. The detailing will be in this area. The Subaru repair will be here. All Subarus will be brought in through this one garage door in the back.
And will there be any windows or access bays along the southern rear wall of the building facing the adjacent property?
No.
And why is it necessary to expand the existing operations on this property?
Our Subaru repair facility, we just have, we're 2 weeks out sometimes right now for repairs.
And what are the hours of operation?
8:00.
And will all repairs be contained within the building?
Correct.
And in your opinion, will any noise generated by the operations of the building be contained on the property so as not to disturb the neighboring property owners?
It will be contained within the building.
And are you familiar with the concerns that were raised by the adjacent property owner?
Yes.
And have you agreed to install the buffering along the property line as described by Mr. Anderson earlier this evening?
Yes, we have.
And will you continue to work with the neighbor as to the location of the proposed landscaping?
Yes.
And would you agree, as a condition of approval, to paint the rear southern wall of the building a dark green to color to minimize the visual impact of the building through that landscaping?
Yes.
And would you also agree as a condition of approval to design the proposed addition so that there are no windows or doors along that southern rear wall?
Yes, we would.
And would you agree as a condition to install motion-activated full cutoff lights along the rear of the building?
Yes, we would.
Would you also agree that no bodywork or painting would take place on the property?
Agreed.
And marked as Exhibit A7 in the board's packet is a list of proposed conditions. If the relief is granted this evening, is it your understanding that the applicant is willing to accept these conditions as part of the approval?
Yes.
I have no further questions for Mr. Alexander at this time.
Thank you. Ms. Shields?
Yes. Mr. Alexander, where precisely are new vehicles delivered when they're delivered to this facility, and by what means?
It's, I guess, the car carrier that we've all seen. We usually have 10 cars on them. They'll pull on the lot and unload there. Years ago, we were unloading on Pennsylvania, right at Kerr Park, and it wasn't good. So we had to get them out of there. So now we moved all the new car carriers are directed to go to Norwood to drop new cars off.
And when they do that, they park at times on the eastbound Route 30 ramp, correct?
On the on-ramp, if I have two trucks there, yeah, they'll park on the side, unload them there, and then on the ramp. So we get two trucks in there, it gets a little tight.
Do you happen to know how tall this new addition will be? Better a question for who's going to answer. Do you know what the height would be? Just out of curiosity. Don't know?
No, I do not, no.
Do you know if it's the same height as the existing structure?
I don't know that. It should be. The existing structure is I don't see any need to be any higher, but I don't know. I'll find that out.
Those are the only questions that I have.
The just looking at the building height, to answer your question on the site plan, it is the maximum building height is 35, and we're proposing that it would be less than or equal to 35
okay.
feet in height.
Thank you.
Does that conclude your case?
Yes.
It does. I would like to move to enter my exhibits into the record.
Any objection, Ms. Shields?
No, thank you.
They'll be admitted. All right, at this point, you've concluded.
Correct.
We're going to allow people from the audience to either ask questions or make a statement. So is there anyone interested in speaking to us regarding this application?
I just have one question. I may have heard wrong, but could you please clarify the lot width at the front of the new addition?
The lot width at the new addition is located right about here. It's 187 feet, 187.29 feet. And that's shown on the plan.
All right, thank you. Yes, ma'am, you had it.
You want to go first? Well, you go first.
Okay. Paul Bain, 304 North Lake Drive.
Sorry, please say your last name again.
Bain, B-A-N-E.
B-A-N-E, yeah. And your address?
304 North Lake Drive.
Thank you.
Yes, are there any provisions being put in behind the property for the trees to block the billboard?
There, the proposed plan does not include any landscaping. There is an easement, a 50-foot wide easement that is given to the borough for the borough to use for landscaping.
Okay.
But the applicant is not proposing that landscaping. That would be for the borough to do.
Right. Is there, has there been any communication between the borough and Roberts as to when that project would take place?
I don't believe so.
Smoke. Well, that's why we're here, because we all got certified letters.
Well, you got certified letters to tell you that the hearing was going to occur.
Mm-hmm.
So if you want to make a comment, you have to tell us who you are, give us your address, tell your last name.
Bobby Jo Brumo, 302 North Lake Drive.
Spell your last name, please.
Excuse me?
Can you spell your last name, please?
B-R-O-O-M-E-L-L.
Thank you.
I guess my question now is directed to Steve Sullins, because we were told that trees were going to be planted to buffer the billboard.
I think I can clear up probably a lot of this. Steve Sullins, Downingtown Borough Manager. We approached Roberts. There's been a change in management. We since contacted the new management. We requested a 50-foot blanket easement on the back of the property. We did not ask this applicant to install the trees. We have another commitment from the actual billboard company. We're working with them to get a planning schedule, but we needed the easement recorded with this plan so that we can put the trees in. So that's going to be taken care of by the billboard company, not the applicant of this proceeding. So the only thing we asked of them was for the easement. That's shown on the plan and will be recorded with the plan if the plan is approved, and we'll go from there for the trees. But that's a separate issue with the trees and a different company. So,
Bobby Joe again, and I understand that the agreement was not between for Roberts to plant the trees, but I want to know where the easement is and where the trees are going to be planted by the billboard company.
I think the easement is depicted on the plan, if I'm not mistaken.
And the last time I saw the plan, I have lived at my house only for a year and a half, and it has the owner of the property as being the one that owned it two times before I did. So I would like the legalities of that to be cleaned up, and I want to know exactly where the easement is and where the trees are going to go by the billboard company. Is there a Pico right away back there also where the easement is?
Yeah.
And does Pico know you're going to plant trees there?
It's not part of their
easement. It's not on their easement.
Oh.
I don't know. And another thing I have to say is, by my yard going down to where this property already is, there's a lot of trucks in that lot early in the morning, headlights shining, noise, so. And they don't even know how tall the building's going to be. I mean, no one answered that question, did they?
I think she did answer the question.
I thought it was supposed to be
I think the answer was it would not exceed the permissible height for that zoning area.
24 bays. And the neighbor is going to be the townhouses that are going to go in that have buffering right now, not the people on 302, not the people on North Lake Drive, as the way I understand it. Am I correct?
That is correct. And the buffering, right now we're not proposing any change of use in the rear of the property. The buffering was to minimize the impact of the proposed building addition.
Yes, ma'am.
Hi, I'm Shawna Kelly, 308 North Lake Drive.
Spell your last name, please.
Oh, Kelly, K-E-L-L-Y. In order for the trees to get put in, do they have to talk to them first?
I understand from Mr. Sullins that there's going to be an easement, and we don't know the terms of that easement, but the easement's going to give the borough permission to put trees there.
Right, so what I'm saying is, does the billboard company have to talk to them first? Like, yeah, I get that they're going to put an easement there, that's fine. But is there going to be communication before that happens, or no?
I would assume so, because they're going to have to go across their property to get to the easement, so...
So, and you guys are saying that you guys have not been contacted at all about this?
Well, I believe the applicant has been in discussions with the borough, but
correct.
As far as timing and all of the logistics, I don't know that that's been...
They've been talking to them for a pretty long time, so, but they haven't contacted you guys yet to say, hey, we're doing this, right? You have no contact with
Mr. Sullins here. Indicated that it would not go forward. Right now, it's a proposed easement.
I got the easement. I understand.
I don't think you have the easement. That's why I'm trying to explain it to you. There's a proposed easement. That easement will not actually come into existence until they're through their entire process and the plan is actually recorded in Westchester at the Recorder of Deeds office and then also on file with the borough. So it is at that point that the borough would acquire the easement or the right to have candidate. I just want you to understand that that's part of the timing issue here, is that this is proposed, but it's not cast in concrete at this point in time.
How long is that going to take them, until this is all complete?
The Zoning Hearing Board has 45 days, assuming that the hearing concludes tonight, the Zoning Hearing Board has 45 days to render a decision. And then I think the question is whether they have to go through any part of the land development process with the borough. And if they have to go through land development, that'll depend upon the land development process.
Bram Kelly, K-E-L-L-Y, 308 North Lake Drive. So I just want to clarify the buffer with the trees on the side is for the proposed townhouse community, not for the existing homes that are already in place on North Lake Drive. We're more concerned about
if I understand it correctly, you have an eastern boundary, which is the boundary that is closest to Lake Drive, and then you have a southern boundary, which is where the proposed townhouse development would be. So the only thing being depicted on this plan at this point in time is a landscape buffer on the south boundary.
So why are we only putting a landscape buffer on a proposed townhome community and not on existing homes that are already part of the borough?
Mr. Sullins explained to you that was going to be, that's being worked out with someone else.
But that's been worked out for a couple of years now, year and a half. I mean, why? I have no faith in Mr. Sullins and his ability to get that project done. So why wouldn't it be included in the existing project that's going forward
from
now?
From a zoning hearing standpoint, this is actually not an issue for the zoning hearing board, the landscape board.
So you're more concerned about the zoning committee is more concerned about a proposed townhome community than existing homes?
It's not that we're concerned about it. They're trying to give you full disclosure about the plan. So they've indicated that they're going to do a landscape buffer. The landscape, what the Zoning Hearing Board is concerned about is
that they have requested a variance from three different provisions of the zoning ordinance. Landscape buffers have nothing to do with what is being requested of the zoning hearing board.
What if we wanted to request that?
I would suggest that you get involved in the land development process when it goes in front of the planning commission and borough council. That's who would deal with that.
And if I may just address one point, the landscaping that's being proposed along the southern boundary is also to minimize the impact due to the fact that we're not complying with the side yard setback. Because we aren't complying with the 50 feet, we're only 37 and a half feet away. Whereas in the back area along the properties on North Lake Drive, we do already comply with the required buffer as well as the setback. In fact, we're over 150 feet away from the property line, and that area is already wooded. So again, I mean, that would be something that would be addressed during the land development process, which we will have to go through if the board is inclined to grant the relief that's requested this evening.
And one more thing, I've never seen a car carrier in the lot. I've only seen them on the 30 bypass entrance. And every time I've seen them, there's only been one truck. So I've never seen a truck enter the lot to unload vehicles. And I live right next to this lot. I mean, that would require the truck to back into the lot, because there's no way for a semi-truck to turn around in that lot. So I've never seen that. They always pull on the 30 bypass entrance there to unload their cars.
All right, thank you. Yes,
ma'am. Sarah Brown, East Brandywine Township. Brown, B-R-O-W-N. I work at Pacer Pool Services, and yes, I have been behind the truck that it's trying very hard to get into the doorways that go into that rectangular lot. Trying to be on time at work can be painful. So I'm very grateful that it's up on the side, on the entrance ramp.
Thank you, Cindy. Anyone else?
Bobby Joe Bruno, 302 North Lake Drive, B-R-O-O-M-E-L-L. Now, there's not woods that separate our houses from Roberts at every point. Actually, you can go up to a fence and hear and see everything. How long is the building going to take of 24 bays?
How long is the building?
Yeah. No, how long will it take to build 24 bays? How much noise are we going to hear from that? And again, with Mr. Kelly, I can't believe that Roberts, who has been here forever, is going to have plant trees for a townhouse community that's not built yet, but yet for the existing residents that have been here forever, won't do anything for us. And I understand we're going to go back to Steve Sullins, and it's going to be that easement, and that might even ever happen for us. So now we not only have a billboard that shines on us because someone allowed that into this town that's five times larger than it ever had to be on Norwood Road, now we're going to have 24 additional bays. No one knows quite the height. They're assuming that. No one knows how long it's going to take to build them. And we're going to hear all that noise.
All of those issues will be addressed during land development. This is only for zoning to request the relief that we need for the side yard setback, the minimum lot width, because that's the first step in the process. If the variances aren't granted, we can't move forward with land development. The buffering anywhere else on the property, there are requirements as far as building height, impervious, buffering, landscaping, things like that. That all gets addressed when we do a fully engineered plan, which will come back before the Planning Commission and Council to receive land development approval. What's shown and what's discussed this evening only relates to the relief that's being requested with respect to the setbacks. The landscape buffering that's specifically shown on the plan was shown as to address concerns of the neighbor where we are asking for the relief on the side yard setback. So with respect to, during the land development process, as we look at the plan in more detail, there may be more buffering. You know, that's something that the applicant, we can take it back to the applicant and request that they take a look at to include that during that land development process.
All right, well, I guess my other question would be, if we say that this can happen, do the neighbors of North Lake Drive have any guarantee the trees are going to be built on the easement, Mr. Sullins?
I mean, I have commitments. I did not speak with the service manager, the engineer, or the attorney. I spoke with the actual owner of the property. He told me if they get their variances and go through, they were fine with granting the easement. I talked to the tree company. He said, I'm fine with you planting it because it will only enhance our property, so we will record the easement. But meanwhile, if we get our variance, we get the first approval, go ahead and plant the trees. That is our conversation that we had.
Can the citizens of North Lake Drive have that in writing?
I mean, I think the borough is committed to putting the trees in, whether the sign company does or not. My goal was to get the easement. The trees will be planted. I mean...
Well, we have one certified letter that came out to us. Can we have that in writing again, that we are guaranteed that we are going to have trees in one way or another?
Well, I think that's a question you need to raise in front of Borough Council.
Well, I'm asking him right now.
Well, he's the township manager, he's the borough manager, and that's not germane to the issues in front of the zoning hearing board. So at some point, we have to cut this off because it doesn't, you're not in the proper form. I know that's very confusing to people, but you
Well,
need
it's
to
not
go.
Confusing, but for us to allow them to do this, we need to get something.
That's not necessarily the way the system works, so I'm sorry. You need to address that, your specific concerns about buffering with Borough Council. Is there anybody else that wants to comment? Yes, Ms. Shields.
Is